Now we travel to the island of Maui in Hawaii, where multi-building schools are designed to withstand natural forces. But protecting against intruders is still a challenge. Student Television Network correspondent Sydney Dempsey looks at how one architect is reimagining spaces that balance security with a healthy learning environment. It's part of our ongoing Student Reporting Lab series called The New Safe, in which student journalists investigate how school communities are adjusting to new concepts of safety in the classroom.
Well, when I first came here, I thought it was really big. And like, I even had to use a map to try and find my way around. And I think I'm still using it today, like just to check and make sure I know where I'm going.
McKaylee Chalmers, a Maui High sophomore, has had her fair share of campuses. But after 7 schools and 5 states, something about Hawaii still stands out.
It's nice to be outdoors and get some fresh air.
Yeah, Hawaii is in that, I think as all of us here live here know, you know, we have a climate that is pretty much comfortable year-round.
But over the years, Charles Kanishiro, the president of an international architecture firm based in Honolulu, sees a storm brewing in his industry.
The majority of our schools in Hawaii are older. So they're designed to standards that existed 50 years ago. The more current schools are being designed with school safety in mind. And obviously that's because of, you know, Columbine or more recently Sandy Hook. I don't think anybody 20 years ago would even imagine, you know, something like that happening in a public school. I mean, we send our kids to go to school to learn, not to be killed.
We're in an old building.
Where is that?
Oh.
Alcansel has worked as a school resource officer for 3 years. He says he has noticed that with the rising risk of school violence, there are inherent challenges with protecting schools with multiple buildings.
Trespassers can gain access to our campus 360 degrees, making it nearly impossible for us to maintain a secure campus unless we had the manpower to hold hand by hand and surround the school. It's pretty much somebody out.
There's all this fear now that I might send my son or daughter to school and they may not come home. And so there's a tendency to want the schools to become a prison. And that's the trade-off. You know, if we design our schools as prisons, then can you imagine the type of education that's going to occur in them?
If there was bars displayed, metal detectors that they have to go through, there's this constant unsettled feeling. All of that creates a culture of anxiety and hypervigilance, which when you're in a hypervigilant state, which is watching out for danger, it's very hard to learn.
Toby Neal, a licensed clinical social worker at Maui Center for Child Development and a previous counselor at multiple Hawaii schools, suspects that fear-driven architecture may detach children from their roots.
We did not evolve inside of buildings. And I think the optimal learning environment includes nature.
In order to balance the two, a good learning environment and a safe area is by having what we call zones of supervision. So instead of less glass, there's actually more glass.
Pu'u Kakui Elementary School features large hurricane windows, which can hold form even when cracked to impact. Open areas within immediate distance of protected spaces, unobtrusive chain link gates, which subtly control access points, a campus-wide alert system, and staff distributed so that every corner of campus is under adult supervision at all times.
It's not designing a completely tragic-proof school. You can't do that, and that would be a prison.
Ultimately, it's about balancing security with nurturing learning environments so students like McKaylee can enjoy what makes school school. She believes children should be able to
come to school and just focus on their work and seeing their friends and not have to worry about, like, their well-being or anything.